Consolidation of city services. Well, more changes for employee benefits as well. All of that, Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake said today, needs to be on the table. The mayor delivered her State of the City address. I-Team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live outside City Hall tonight with details. Jane.
Marianne, the mayor spent some time today in her State of the City address on the topic of employee benefits, not a favorite subject of the unions. But from one union president tonight, a surprising suggestion about something else the mayor talked about today, hiring more cops. The 45-minute speech by Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake was full of blunt language about the financial challenges the city faces.
Today, more than ever, we're at a crossroads.
Calling it the new normal, the mayor rolled out the blueprint for a 10-year financial plan intended to reshape city government. Tough choices, she said, must be made.
How do we keep core services like public safety, public schools, and sanitation fully funded? What programs can we live without? What can we afford to spend on benefits for employees compared to what we can spend on direct services to our citizens?
The mayor focused on the fast rising cost of benefits for employees and retirees. More changes, she said, are likely.
Baltimore spends more on employee benefits than we do on our entire police department.
Police and fire unions are fighting the mayor's reforms to their pension system approved last year. The police union president did not comment on what the mayor said today. He did challenge her plan to hire hundreds of new police officers.
That maybe the answer isn't hiring more police next year, which will further hurt your unfunded liability on employee benefit costs, but taking care of the men and women who you have here right now serving the good citizens of this city. And I welcome them to that debate. And if they want a real progressive discussion, let's sit down and talk.
The mayor has a 2-year plan to add several hundred police officers to cover attrition. Now, the mayor also touched in her speech today on the city's high property tax rate. Yes, she said she does want to reduce it, but she warned, this being an election year, of what she called too good to be true proposals that might come from others. Reporting live tonight from City Hall, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.